the backlot of Universal Studios in Los Angeles. Soundstage 12, where dancers, camera crews, comedian Eddie Murphy, Magic Johnson, and supermodel Iman have all gathered for the shooting of Michael Jackson's song, Remember the Time. A short film, not a video, directed by John Singleton, best known for Boys in the Hood.
Come on, let's do it once more. Once more. I don't need again, quit.
This is actually probably the biggest production I've ever worked on. You know, I'm used to doing small films inside of, you know, houses and neighborhoods, and this is the first time I've ever worked on a soundstage. It's kind of like I got every toy at my disposal. You know, if I want it and I feel it's going to look right, I just go and I tell somebody, I want this, you know, and if Michael wants it too, I get it. It all happens in ancient Egypt. The storyline is this. The queen of Egypt, Nefertiti, is bored, played by Iman, the queen, and she asked the pharaoh, played by Eddie Murphy, if he can find some way to entertain her. He decides to call in a couple of entertainers, so he has some people come, he has a juggler come, and he has a fire breather come, and the queen is still not satisfied.
Think that I'm running and I'm a punk because Iman didn't move from the bird. But it's two ways to react in a situation like that. You can run or be real still. And she's just being real still. But she's as horrified as I am. And see, she was raised in East Africa. She knows if the eagle go crazy, be real still. I'm from Brooklyn, so you run.
Remember the Time is like my favorite track on the album. You know, there's a lot of good tracks, but it's like, you know, I really like it because it has a dance feel, but it's also kind of like a ballad too. It has kind of multi-dimensions to it.
Mike got a funky beat. Ooh, it's nice. I'm just excited to be here and have an opportunity to be on this video, or I should say short movie. And I mean, I'm like a little kid. What can I tell you?
You're gonna be the announcer. You're gonna be the person announcing to the Pharaoh Ramses all the performers and stuff.
Okay.
Behold, great Pharaoh Ramses, I bring to you the Stick Man.
One thing I really like about dancing, I'm doing some kind of like Busby Berkeley kind of things. And that stuff overhead in different angles, and I'm cutting on movement. A lot of people don't think about that. Most people, when they do videos or short films or whatever, when they shoot dance, all they do is they keep the camera going, and they don't choreograph for the camera. They don't choreograph dance for the camera. I got a friend of mine, Fatima Robinson, to choreograph it, and she's worked a lot with Guy, and she worked with Whitney Houston and some other people and stuff, and it's just like, it's some real funky stuff, you know?
What we did was took some hip-hop moves, but made them technical, because Mike is very technical. We put some hip-hop, which is the latest dance style right now.
The best dance.
And brought it all together. We've been working on this for around 3 weeks. Yeah, a couple weeks rehearsal and dress rehearsal and everything like that.
And about 8-hour, 9-hour days.
Yeah, pretty hectic. We're working with 25 plus Michael. 13 girls and 12 guys plus Michael. We both decided to dance because a lot of times when choreographers don't dance, they don't get the same respect, especially from dancers, because you're not doing the same thing. You're just saying, okay, do that and do this. But when they see you, you know, busting your butt too, they give you more respect.
And they work harder.
Exactly.
Yeah, I like that.
And the dancing.
So I need some sandbags, some apple boxes to balance this.
The 4x4 box on camera right, bring that up.
Dancers, get ready. All right, right here. All right, whenever you want. All right, attitude, Mike.
It's like live, you know. I'm not limited by my imagination for once in my life, because Michael's not limited by his imagination.